Homicide has been one of the leading causes of death among the nation's youth, with firearms being the murder weapon of choice. However, while there have been attempts made by law enforcement and government officials to address the situation, the effectiveness of their strategies has been questioned. The latest arrest of three young men, including two brothers, for murder has caught the attention of the National Youth Council.
We think that many of those young persons, we want to inquire as to where those young persons acquire those ammunition, those guns, those weapons. And we think that, you know, many of those young people need to realize that, you know, the way in which they deal with their issues, their differences with one another is not the way in which it should be done. And we want to encourage them to find a more amicable way to resolve problems and situations that they may have, you know, amongst themselves. And we find that this is a growing issue, and many of the younger and even younger persons are being found with guns and other weapons in various communities around the island.
According to the NYC president, young people growing up in conflict situations are usually faced with greater challenges as violent conflict impacts negatively on all dimensions of their lives. At the same time, feelings of exclusion can contribute to the emergence or continuation of violence.
We can look at certain of these topics being included in developmental workshops through the clubs. You have many young persons who take part in football, etc., cricket, and I think those clubs should take the opportunity to reach out and develop those young persons and add that to their holistic approach to the development of the young athletes as well.
Just last week, Youth Development and Sports Minister Edmund Estefan announced plans to use sports as a tool to tackle crime. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.